Welcome to the leaf exercise meditation. This exercise is designed to develop the muscle of your mind so that you are able to use Neville Goddard's visualization techniques. And in doing so, you will be able to create anything you want by using your imagination. Follow this exercise until you can reach the title of Master Meditator, which is reaching and counting 50 leaves without your mind drifting one time. And in doing so, you will be able to create the life of your dreams by using your imagination. I am going to guide you through the exercise, but when I'm finished explaining this process and walking you through it, you must use your own imagination to recreate it. It's important that you develop your own ability to visualize and your own ability to imagine, using all of the faculties of your senses in your imagination to recreate a three-dimensional space within your imagination. Okay, so the first thing I want you to do is get to a place where you're not going to be disturbed for quite a few minutes. And when you do that, I want you to either sit down or lay down, relax in a position where you're not going to fall asleep, but where you can focus your attention on your imagination and your visualization. So now that you're relaxed and in a place where you're not going to be disturbed for a little while, I want you to close your eyes and imagine and visualize that you're sitting in a field of grass beside a pond. So you have a pond or a body of water in front of you. And overlooking this body of water or pond is the sun. And the sun is setting. You can see it very clearly. You can create some clouds near the sun if you would like. And you can feel the warmth of the sun on your face right now. So imagine the pond. You're sitting in grass. There's a pond in front of you. And then overlooking the pond is the sun. And it's setting. It's not too intense. But you can still feel the warmth of the sun on your skin, on your face, on your arms, on your legs. You can feel it all. And to the left and the right side of the pond is trees, wildlife. You can create it any which way you would like. You want to hear birds or crickets, you can create those sounds if you would like to intensify the realness of this imaginal act. So you're sitting in grass with your legs crossed. There's a pond in front of you. You can feel the sun, which is overlooking the pond in front of you. And on the left and right side of this pond is wildlife, which is trees. You see birds flying. You can hear crickets. Just create it however you would like, as simple as you would like or as much detail as you would like. And as you get situated and comfortable with this visualization in this imaginal scene, I want you to picture a leaf in the sky above the pond. So it relatively would be around 20 feet above the pond, the leaf. And you can create any leaf you would like, any leaf that would be very familiar to you. That way you can picture it in detail. And it's probably about 20 feet in front of you and 20 feet above the pond. So when you imagine this leaf, the first thing I want you to do is imagine it falling and it's swaying from left to right very slowly, and your attention needs to be fixed on this leaf and only this leaf. So you've created the scene, the pond, the sun, the wildlife, the trees, the birds, the noises, the warmth of the skin from the sun. And now I want you to focus solely on the leaf. So it falls from the sky. You can see it It's swaying left to right, left to right, left. It sways about 10 times before it hits the water. So focus on the leaf, and when your mind drifts, you have to bring it back. Bring it back to that leaf and start over again. So the leaf is swaying 3-4 times, left to right, left to right, left to right, left to right, left to right. Then the leaf hits the water in the pond. And as the leaf hits the water in the pond, you notice that the water ripples like a little wave from the impact of the leaf on the water. You notice the ripple is coming right to the shoreline where you're sitting in front of the pond. You watch the ripple, and as that water ripples and it hits the shoreline, you go to your next leaf. You look back up in the sky and create another leaf. Whatever leaf is the most familiar to you. And then it starts again. 20 feet in front of you, 20 feet above the pond. The leaf is swaying left to right, left to right, left to right. You're watching it as it sways and comes all the way down to the water. Left to right, it's still going. Left to right, focus your attention on the leaf and nothing else. It hits the water ripples to the shoreline. You're watching the ripples and nothing else, focused on nothing else but the leaf and the ripple of the water to the shoreline. And when it reaches the shoreline, you start again on the next leaf. Now you create the next leaf. It's falling again. Number three, swaying left to right, left to right, left to right, left to right, all the way down. It's coming down. It hits the water. The water ripples all the way to the shoreline. There it goes. You can see the water ripple. And now you watch the ripple in the water reach the shoreline where you're sitting. Then you begin the process again. Start with the leaf in the sky 20 feet above the pond. It's swaying from left to right, all the way down to the pond. And if your mind drifts to something other than the leaf during this process, or the ripple of the water, you must start again at one. This exercise is designed to develop your ability to focus on one thing and use your imagination to create anything you want in your life. When you can increase your level of visualization and your level of focus on one thing for long periods of time, you will be able to capture a feeling in a visual scene and hold it there. And you'll be able to use this new muscle of your mind to attract anything you want to you during the day in your 3D world, or imagine and visualize anything you want before you go to sleep at night or during the day and attract to you anything that you want in your life. But do not stop doing this exercise until you get to 50 leaves without your mind drifting one time. And when you can do this, when you can reach 50 leaves without your mind drifting once, everything in your life will change. You will be in complete control of your reality, complete control of your imagination, your thoughts, your inner dialogue, your inner talking. You will be able to control everything that happens to you and attract to you everything that you want to come into your life. So I'm going to go over this exercise one more time with you, and then you must create this visual scene on your own. You must visualize this entire scene exactly how I'm laying it out and follow these instructions. So, you're sitting in grass in front of a pond. Overlooking the pond is a sun. It's setting, it's not too powerful, it's not burning your skin, but you can feel the warmth of the sun on your face and your skin. And to the left and the right of the pond is wildlife. There's trees, bushes, birds. You can create whatever you want, whatever sounds you want to make this more real to you. And when you create the scene and make it vividly real, the next step is to create a very familiar leaf. Whatever leaf is very familiar to you and is easy to visualize, and you're very familiar with the detail of this leaf. I use a maple leaf because that's very familiar in my imagination. So when you do this, imagine the maple leaf or whatever leaf, or if you want to use a $100 bill, a $50 bill, a $20 bill, that's also fine. Imagine it in the sky, 20 feet in front of you, 20 feet above the pond, and it's swaying slowly from left to right. And it's going to sway from left to right about 10 to 15 times before it hits the water. After it hits the water, you're going to notice that the water is going to ripple like a small wave from the impacted leaf or bill of any kind. Once that ripple reaches the shoreline, you then go to number 2, and then number 3 subsequently.